Hello students, welcome to the session on Daily MS. In our today's session, we are going to see the introduction about the relational database management system, in which you people will be working actually while you are working in a lab. Okay, and this relational database management system is a model in which we will be having a blueprint of our database, I can say. And this relational model database model is introduced by Edgar F. Carr at IBM. Invented the relational database model in the year of 1970s. Sima, he is also called as what? Father of RDBMS. What is RDBMS? RDBMS is nothing but the relational database management system. Why we need to go for the relational database management system is, this is the simplest way in which you people can understand and you people can hide the implementation procedure of the database system. Okay, the main elements of RDBMS are based on 13 rules that have been explained by this particular map. Okay, and tables are the relations. In this particular model, you will be representing the data in the format of table. That table is also known as a relation, are related to each other by sharing a common characteristics. If you are having multiple tables, if you are having multiple relations in your database, those particular tables, those particular relations will be maintaining the relationship by sharing a common attribute between them. Okay, I hope it is clear to you people what we are having on the slides. I will go for the next slide, which will be explaining few more details about your relational database model. Already we know that it has been introduced by E.F. Carr and represents the table, represents the data in the format of relation itself. Relation is what? Here a table. Okay. And informally, each relation looks like a table of values. Okay. As I told you people, we can store the data in a format of file, we can store the data in a format of tables. For example, if I am storing a student detail, if I am storing like this, student ID, student name, student fee, then it is looking like a table. And the values will be entered into the slides by having the rows and columns. That is what they are saying. Represents a database as a collection of relations. Relations is nothing but the table. Here we are having a student table. Similar to this, we will be having a faculty table. Similar to this, we will be having the examination branch. Similar to that, we will be having some other colleges details. Collectively, they will be forming as a university database. Like that, collection of relations will be represented as what? Databases. Okay, relational database matches the data by using a common attribute. Say suppose if this is the student table, here I will be having one more column, faculty ID, who is teaching this student. Then again I will be having what? Faculty table, where I will be having faculty ID, faculty name, faculty department and faculty subject. So these two tables will be related by using a common column called faculty ID. Faculty ID. Here also we will be having faculty ID. See how we will be related with this. This student is start by whom? This faculty ID will be seen and this faculty ID will be related with this particular table. From here we will be getting the faculty details. Faculty ID, faculty name, faculty department, faculty subject. Like this, each and every table will be related with one another by sharing a common attribute which will be there in all the tables. Okay, the resulting group of data are organized and are much easier for people to understand. These things can be understandable by everyone, those who are not having any knowledge about the database management system also. Even if you are explaining to somebody those who are not related to your computer science subject, they can also easily understand that okay, we can store the data in the format of table. From the data we can pick and from the table itself we can update the data. They can easily understand how we are implementing it, how we are creating the data, how these tables are arranged into your database, how these are physically stored into your physical devices. Those things will be hidden from the user, okay, so that he can easily understand the data that you are going to provide into your databases. Okay, if it is not, they will be having lot amount of questions ma in order to understand your data. Why? Because when you are telling them in a format of table, they can easily understand. If you are telling about the queries, if you are telling about the software that you are going to use, they will be not having that much of knowledge about your database management system, and they will be not having any idea about the queries, how you people will be executing in order to create the tables. But when you are explaining them by giving these pictures, by giving this particular tables, then they can easily understand, then they can easily give you the suggestions what they want to have in their project, what they want to have there in database. Why? Because these databases are clearly prepared for what? Clients. And the clients will not have the knowledge. If they are having the knowledge, then why they will come to you people? Okay, they need to understand the data that you are going to create and you are going to put it in the database, and how it will be related, how it will be retrieved from the database. Those must be explained to clients so that it will be very clear to them and they can easily approve your project in order to develop. Okay, and when we are having the advantages, we will be having the disadvantages of your relational database management system too. But try to understand the advantages. As you people are having multiple things to store in your database, everything, every component of your database will be considered as an individual table, individual relation, where there will be no structural dependency between the table to table. For example, if you are changing any structure in your student, that won't affect in your faculty. If you are changing anything in a faculty table, that won't affect in your student. Okay, like that, it will be providing a structural independence and it promotes it. How to use the independent tables so that it will be not having any clumsiness while using the data. It is very platform independent, not platform independent, it is structural independent. Okay, you can change any structure in your table. Tabular views improves the conceptual simplicity. These table views will be improving as the conceptual schemas, right? We can easily analyze them, we can easily improve them in order to have a better database into our database management system. Okay, it isolates the end users from physical level details. Why we are saying isolating? See, in a physical detail level, we will be not understanding how we are going to prepare the database, how we are going to store the data into the storage devices. All those things will not be understandable by the end user. And in order to not happen that, we are explaining them by using the tables only. They can easily understand, they can easily relate the tables, they can easily go through the complete database in order to go for their development. Okay. And as I already told you people, physical storage details and software details will not be known by them. So in order to make them understand in an easiest manner, we will go for this relational model. And this relational model is very supported by your ad hoc SQL queries, right? Ad hoc query capability is based on your SQLs. Okay, and it improves the implementation. It improves the implementation. Why? Because we can easily design them. As per the design, we could go for the development. Okay, and but whatever the advantages that we have considered, in that, those things will be made as disadvantages. See, it is very easy to construct now, it is very easy to design the tabular format. So, at every level we will be having an individual table. Every individual table can be modified by the client at any time. So, next time when we are going for the development of those particular tables, again we need to modify the structure of those tables. So, those are the disadvantages. Everyone can change, everyone can add a column, everyone can delete the column, and they can change the integrity constraint. And there will be a clumsiness when we are having a lot of users in order to modify the content. Okay. And one more thing is that it needs what? Higher level of hardware and software components. That will become overhead when we are developing the relational model. Why? Because in order to hire the implementation processes, we need high hardware components and software components which will be hiding the complexity. The conceptual simplicity. As I told you people, it is very simple to understand. It is very easy to modify at the user level. They can modify using their tools. But in order to go for entire database management system to understand that, it will be having a poor performance, I can say. Okay. May it promote what? Information problem. As it is updated by each and every person. Okay. And this relationship model this relational model will give us a brief idea about your database, how we are going to store the data. Okay, and when we are going for the other kind of information which is related to your relational database management system model is terms related, the terminology that you are going to use in entire concept of your relational model that we are going to see in our upcoming lecture. I'll be throwing the video for you people, just go through it and try to understand. If there is any doubt, just let me know by your messages and we will discuss them and we'll go for the next concepts. That's it for now. I hope it is clear to you people. See you in the next one. Thank you.